The protection of water resources and the provision of high-quality drinking water is a key priority for public health. The Federal Safe Drinking Water Act protects the public from legacy, well-known contaminants. However, there are certain chemicals, which we call emerging contaminants, that might be present in our drinking water. Emerging contaminants represent a special challenge because the very limited availability of information regarding them. And most importantly, they are not regulated by federal or state. 1,4-dioxane is a stabilizer that has been used with many organic solvents, that it is difficult to be filtered from the drinking water. So wherever there was a chemical spill of solvents, the 1,4-dioxane was with them. And it has been detected in several Superfund sites throughout the United States and internationally. Superfund sites are areas that there is a contamination, a chemical spill, or environmental release of chemicals by the chemical industry. We decided to develop a research center primarily focusing on this chemical. The Yale Superfund Research Center aims to study the role of 1,4-dioxane in human health, as well as better methods of detecting it in the environment and also better ways of mitigating that from the drinking water. Based on studies, 1,4-dioxane is a probable human carcinogen. Therefore, we are aiming to study the molecular mechanism by which 1,4-dioxane, along or with its co-contaminants, may cause cancer. And at the same time, we are aiming to develop biomarkers of exposure to these chemicals, since there is no epidemiological studies confirming the carcinogenicity of this compound in humans. Dr. Diesel and her colleagues are investigating the exposure assessment of 1,4-dioxane in human populations.
Project 2 is an exposure assessment study, which is the study of how people come into contact with chemicals as they move through their everyday lives. This could be pollutants in the air that they breathe, chemicals in the food they're eating, the personal care products they're using, or even contaminants in their drinking water. It's really important to understand what people are exposed to, so we have to know who is exposed to what amounts. Certain populations may have higher levels of these chemicals in their drinking water or in their blood, and that will help us understand whether or not they're at risk for any health problems. Our study area includes two counties on Long Island, Nassau and Suffolk counties, and these two counties are home to dozens of state and federal Superfund sites. We're going to hundreds of homes on Long Island to interview people about the consumer products they're using, collect their drinking water and test it for chemicals, collect blood samples to look for health markers, and map where people live in relation to hazardous waste sites. Another reason why exposure assessment is so important is because by identifying communities with higher levels of exposures, that can help direct some of the interventions. So some of the other projects in the Superfund Center are developing treatment devices that could be deployed in homes that have particularly high levels of 1,4-dioxane or other chemicals in their drinking water.
1,4-dioxane is a very difficult pollutant to treat if it is in groundwater because it's so tiny and it loves water. It doesn't like to stick to the surface. So because of that property, the conventional method to treat pollutants does not work well for 1,4-dioxane. We are trying to use electricity, and electric power is going to produce oxidation power, meaning destruction power. Destruction of 1,4-dioxane by hydroxyl radical is a proven chemistry, but it is extremely difficult to realize in a smaller scale setting. For in this center, what we are trying to do is to make a small modular system. For user's point of view, you just plug in, connect the pipe, and it destroys 1,4-dioxane. That's the goal, and we are at the initial stage of realizing that goal.
So one critically important aspect of the Superfund Center is the Community Engagement Core. And I'm leading that along with Adrian Esposito, who is the Executive Director of Citizens Campaign for the Environment, which is a large grassroots organization based in Long Island that has a long history of working on drinking water quality issues in the study area. It's a very rich partnership between the university and the community, and the community is directly providing input into the science. So as scientists, we're not just going into communities and studying what we think is important. We're asking the people who live there what they're concerned about, and their concerns and ideas are directly informing our research questions and our science. Doing the science is incredibly important, but once the work is done and the results are in, it's really important to format the results and information in a way that's useful to the community and to policymakers.
It is very important that we inform stakeholders and legislators regarding toxic limits of those emerging contaminants in our drinking water. So eventually, we would like to inform policy on setting up standards for our drinking water.